beautiful people, and welcome back to my channel. To those of you who are first time visitors, I am Chelsea Kayla, and for those who are returning visitors and my loyal viewers, you know I love you so much for watching. Okay guys, so please don't forget to click subscribe right at the bottom of here, and if you have any comments or if you just want to say hi, please do so in the comments below. So I'm sure you guessed by now that today was wash day. And I've been transitioning for like 5 months, and this is the update. So this is my natural hair journey. And some of you on Instagram asked me to give you guys a little bit of an update and what has been working for me and what has not been working for me. And yeah, so let's get straight into it. Okay, so this is Vatika. This is actually for type 4 hair, but I've been using it on my 2C hair because I lack moisture. So I realize I've got a lot of protein in my hair, but I do lack moisture, and that is super important. So what I do is I just put it between my fingers, and then on my wet hair, just run it through my hair. Also, if you notice, in the previous segment, I was using Tresemme Botanic range. It's sulfate and paraben free. This is also curl friendly products, natural products. And every time I rinse my hair, so this is tip number one, always do apply your product with your hair upside down, rinse out with upside down. So what I realize this does, and hopefully you can all hear me, is that it adds volume to the top of your head. So that's what I lacked a lot, was volume at the top of my head, and that has helped a lot. Basically, when you're rinsing your hair out and stuff like that, also another reason why you do it with your hair flip is because once you rinse your hair out, remember, most of the water is falling at the top of your head, so that is basically stripping all the conditioner out of your hair that is right on top. You want to leave a little bit of conditioner in your hair also, or some moisture in your hair once you've washed it. So for me, the flipping my hair has made a big difference, because I usually had that tent look where it's flat on top and there's a lot of volume at the bottom. So in order to build that volume, like I said, I always apply all my products with my hair flip, and then also, so for more volume and definition, I just do the plopping method. So yeah, just scrunch, plop, whatever you want to call it. If your hair holds a lot of water, you can use a microfiber towel or a t-shirt. Don't use a cotton towel at all. So yeah, so that's what I do, and you can really see my curls are starting to be defined. Another tip also is, I don't know if you noticed compared to my other videos, is I stopped using a comb altogether. If I had some tangling, which I didn't have today, thank goodness, then I would use a comb, a wide tooth comb, to comb it through just to get the tangles and the knots out. But while washing your hair and that type of thing, I now stopped using a comb because I realized that's what pulls all my curls out. I want to get a Denman brush so badly. I will eventually get my hands on one, but for now, I just use my fingers. So that's just to keep my curls quite like together, and that it doesn't frizz. That's what I'm looking for. That's the word I'm looking for. So no flyaways or frizz. So yeah, I just keep doing this. Yeah. And also another tip is, don't favor just one side of your head. So sometimes you make your path on the right and you keep making it on the right, and your hair eventually just keeps falling that way, and then you lose again volume. So from time to time, I flip it from the one side and I flip it to the other side. That type of thing. Also, if you've noticed, this is a bit shorter in front, and I also just did a little bit of a snip. So as I just went along every month, or every time I do my wash day, I just snip a little bit of the ends off. So if I see any dead ends or split ends, I'll just snip it off. Also, I did a length check recently, and when I did the length check, that was actually the best time for me to just snip off all the dry and dead ends, because you see it way better when your hair is blown out. Okay, cool. So once most of the moisture is out, what I then do is, which is my secret weapon, is I'm gonna get it for you. So this is my secret weapon. this is an oil. You need to choose your oil according to what your hair needs. So some people use coconut oil because they need more moisture and a lot more, what's the word I'm looking for? Protein. This is basically for strength, gives strength and shine to the hair. So my hair is very dull, or it was very dull, and I needed a lot of more shine. So the Amla oil works well for shine and also for the scalp as well. I had a bit of a dry scalp, so this helps a lot. What helps is that it's got a nice point. So either I can pour it into my hand or pour it straight onto the scalp. What I do is, if like I was swimming now, or my scalp was really dry, I just put a few drops on the inside of my scalp and then I let it run down to the rest of my scalp. It's also super important for hair growth and to stimulate the growth, to give your hair a little bit of massage. So you use just your fingertips. Also, don't be too rough, else you're going to get flyaways. But this also helps with building volume. So just to get a little bit of volume on the roots, and also to get that oil and stimulate the your roots of your hair for growth and so on. Just give your hair a little, just with your fingertips, little tiny circles. It makes all of the difference. Oil is also a sealant. So you can choose your oil of choice. Like I said, coconut oil, I would love some shea oil or some shea butter or something like that. But for now, Amla oil is easy to get in the shop. So that's my oil of choice. Some people use glycerin, some people use castor oil, whatever. Again, I don't rake or anything like that or use a comb. I just use the plopping method again and the scrunching method just to get that product in to my hair. I try and put the product between my hands. And then I just, as I'm scrunching and plopping, I just put my fingers in between it. Okay, so I feel like my hair is being favoring this side today. So we're going to do this side. Okay. And then last but not least, so it's the curl activating cream. And then the oil as a sealant. And then this is just to keep the curls in its place. It's the Eco Styler Gel. This is for naturally dry hair. It works really well for the specific purpose. So I just take about that much of the product. So a lot of curl activating cream because I've got dry hair. Just a few drops of oil, and then the gel I use about that much, just so that it covers my hands completely. Again, what I just do is kind of focus on the ends and plop from the bottom up, just for more volume and definition. And what I like to do also is I like to throw it all over and then plop, plop, plop like that. I try to keep everything together as possible because I feel like when my hair starts to separate, that's when the flyaways come and the frizz starts. So like I said, I love to flip my hair over and just keep everything. Yeah. Cool. So what I do is then I part it there. And then we flip it up. Okay. What is also super important is when I go and sleep at night, if my hair is like this. This is like your best friend, a silk or satin pillowcase. That is a must. So it's good for your hair and for your skin. It basically, if you've got dry hair or dry skin, you don't want to sleep on anything cotton because it absorbs the oils, the natural oils from your skin and from your hair. So if you're using that satin or the silk case, it basically keeps that moisture and it doesn't absorb any oil or product or anything like that out of your hair. Okay, cool. So what I do now is I try not to lean on anything. I try to stay out of the wind. That is so important because once you go into that wind, the flyaways. So I would suggest what I do is before I go out, I do my hair first. First things first, do my hair. So that I'm in the house and when I'm walking around, my hair can get air dried. I don't use any heat. So my hair will get air dried, and then as I do my makeup and all that jazz, my hair gets dry before I have to go out. It's so important because the flyaways are terrible with a slight breeze even. Oh my goodness, the frizz is real. So yeah, that's my routine. It's been tough. I'm not gonna say it's been easy, especially when I'm sick, and I was sick twice within the past 5 months. It's hard to have curly hair, but let me tell you, it is so rewarding. And if you do your hair properly and you take the time to research how and what works for your hair, it's really rewarding. Because for me, I always thought when my hair was curly, I would get headaches, or my hair would be heavier, or it gets dirty quicker, or whatever. If you take care of your hair, actually, my hair is actually lighter when it's in curls. Like, as in weight. It's so much lighter, because when I blew my hair out, my hair felt so thick because I had so much hair. So, yeah, for me, it just worked out amazing. It is working out amazing. I don't think I'll change anytime soon. I would like to get a diffuser for the winter time. Summertime, it's fine. That's not a problem for me, but I'm just afraid about winter. So for those of you who know really good diffusers, please pop it below in the comments. Let me know. Send me links. And if a diffuser works for you or not, any advice on how to take care of natural curly going into winter, because it'll be my first winter being a natural. And I'm super excited. So that's the update, fam. If there's anything you'd like to know, anything you would like to see me do in future, please drop in the comments below, and I'll definitely do a winter update for y'all. I love you all for watching, and if you liked anything in this video, please give me a heart, a thumbs up. You know how it goes. So till next time, toodaloo.